When did you start high jumping?
Sixth grade.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so, and I know, you know, I think you've mentioned this, maybe you even tweeted it on your Twitter. How do you see the relationship between high jumping and being a wide receiver? Obviously, you make some catches that are pretty, ball jumping high.
Most of it is, you know, when you got a jump ball and you got to make the catch, I think knowing how to time your jump and judge the flight of the ball or how high you need to jump, mm-hmm. I think really plays a big role with track it also. With track, you got to make sure your approach is the same and consistent, make sure your steps is right. Make sure your plant foot is right on point, not too far away from the bar, but not too close. And I think that timing right there really helped me. I've been jumping ever since I was a little kid, so I got the gift of it, I guess.
When did you first realize you could jump really? I guess sixth grade.
I really didn't. I was in sixth grade. I was about 13 years old, and we was in the gym messing around at recess. And everyone was trying to touch the rim, and I was like, man, let me go try it. And I grabbed the rim and I hung on it, and everybody was going crazy. And they was like, try to dunk the ball. And they gave me a ball, and I dunked the ball. And that's when I realized that I could jump pretty high.
That's amazing. Wait, so, I mean, can you think of any specific catches from, the season that, really involved this kind of body control? It's not even just jumping high, it sounds like you're saying. It's more like the approach and the timing and all that stuff.
And I had to go back. But I mean, with the one hand catch that I had, that plays a big role in it. Some of the catches where you see me, leap for it, is will really exemplify, those skills that I have.
Right.
And I think, this past year, with doing track, I really got my approach down, and I think that's why I was so successful, indoor and outdoor Big Tens. Just the small details. I knew the jumping ability was always there, but it was the mechanics that really come with high jump. And, once you get those down, everything else falls into place.
Yeah, and last question, probably the most famous catch of this football season, college or pro, was that Odell Beckham grab. It was just a huge stage thing, just in football, and it was this thing. And, of course, college people were pointing out first that he did that at LSU, too. Second of all, that he's not the only one who can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Did that inspire you at all? Was that kind of that's cool? Did you think it was a great catch, too?
Yeah, absolutely. That was an unbelievable catch. But I was watching it, and I remember watching it, and after he made that catch, everybody was tweeting me like, oh, he did it first. And everybody was tweeting a picture of my one hand catch because they said it looked similar. But when you make a play like that, man, it's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
And but for him, you see him during warm-ups always catching the ball one hand. So I'm sure if you probably asked him, it was probably nothing to him when he did it.
Right. Thanks so much, Ed.
Thank you.
What's the most important catch you had? Didn't you have a big one against Michigan State the first year?
Yeah, 2012.
Second.
He was a sophomore.
Right,
sophomore.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, Urban's first year. Right. Urban's first year. Where's that rank?
That's up there. And there's been so many plays I really can't
think of. Didn't it? Kind of.
Yeah. Kind of turned the game around a little bit. So.
And the season.
It was an unbelievable moment. With Urban coming here, and he really didn't believe in his team that much. At the beginning, and I felt like after that game, that's when he started believing in his team, and after that point, he started coaching, the team different.
In what way? Explain that to me.
Instead of, him complaining or us complaining about something, it was more the finer details that we needed to do to keep winning, and I think he, constantly reminded us we have to grind to win, and that's what we did, and, last year we did it, and had the hiccups in the last two games, and with this year, I think it's starting to click. And I think right after that Virginia Tech loss, it really sunk in to everyone, and we just went on with the season.
Yeah.